Isaiah, good to have you on the program. Congratulations on the raise. When we talk about small modular reactors, you're not alone. NanoNuclear, Oklo, NuScale, just a handful of the companies working on this technology. What makes Valar's different?
Yeah, Tim, it's a huge pleasure to be on with you today, and it's a really exciting day for Valar. It's a great question. There are a lot of people tackling this very, very difficult problem of how do we make all of the energy needs that America has in the future. You know, the thing that sets Valar apart is two things. One is that we're building very quickly. When we started this company, we realized that there was a gap in the physical hardware. We wanted to actually build reactors and test them out very rapidly. I started this company about 2 years ago, and earlier this year, we unveiled our fully complete thermal prototype of our reactor. That's just incredible speed. We haven't seen that kind of speed in nuclear in a long time. The other thing that sets us apart is that we want to build these to be manufacturable. We're sort of moving away from this era of nuclear that's driven by construction and more into mass manufacturing. We want to pump these things out like they're a car, like they're a bus, and that's what's going to drive the cost down and also add a lot to safety as well.
Before you pump these things out, though, you got to build one single example of one that actually works. And here in the United States, there is still no example of a small modular reactor that is up and running, that is online. Taking your company out of the mix, just when do you think there will be an example of that in the U.S.?
That's exactly right. We don't have any small modular reactors running in the U.S. today. And in fact, even though there have been many nuclear startups who have sort of attempted this, there's never been a nuclear startup which has yet split the atom. So I think the next 12 months are going to be extremely exciting. In May of this year, the president signed an executive order ordering three American nuclear companies to turn on SMRs by July 4th of next year. Our company was one of those companies selected. So I think I can confidently say before July 4th, there will be at least one, we hope three SMRs running in the United States, and we definitely think that Valar will have one of those.
How much do they cost? How much will it cost? What's the ultimate goal?
So the initial goal is to beat natural gas. I think nuclear absolutely has to compete with natural gas on price, on timeline, on all of these things that developers care about. So that's the initial goal. A nat gas plant's going, you know, somewhere between $1,000 and $2,000 a kilowatt. So we want to be at least with parity. Now, we're also cleaner, right? So it's not just that we're the same price, it's that we're cleaner as well. But the thing that's interesting about nuclear is that it's actually fairly new, and there's a lot to go down the tech tree, right? There's a lot of technological innovation that can happen in the future. So we expect that price to continue dropping. You know, I think about SpaceX when we talk about this, where rockets used to cost $50,000 a kilogram into orbit, and SpaceX pushed them down to $2,000. I think we're going to look at that level of drop. There's going to be a massive, massive drop in the price as Valar gets really good at making these reactors and makes many of them.
You announced earlier this year that you're suing the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, the NRC. Why are you doing that?
Yeah, you know, I think the thing that is really important in nuclear today is allowing innovation to happen, right? If you think about the role of a regulator, they're trying to figure out how to make sure that we have safety and security across thousands of reactors deployed all over the place. But what was missing in American nuclear was the innovation layer. We need to be able to turn on test units and make sure that they work well. And that's sort of the layer that's missing. So our lawsuit really addresses a gap in how the Code of Federal Regulations has been written versus how the law is written. And so, you know, we're excited about that. Mm. We're also very excited about the Department of Energy. These executive orders signed earlier this year have also opened up incredible pathways to be able to move quickly, turn our reactors on, safely test them before we go and scale.
You know, Palmer, we're showing an image there of different investors in the company, Palmer Luckey of Anduril, among those investors, certainly thinking about the defense space and his involvement there. What are the applications of your technology when it comes to defense for the United States?
That's exactly right. You know, American military bases all around the world are generally dependent on their local grid for power. This has become a massive vulnerability as grids have become vulnerable to cyber attack, you know, by our competitors. And so this is a way for us to actually secure American military bases abroad. We want to see these reactors deployed on bases. A couple of months ago, the Janus program was announced under the U.S. Army to do exactly this, to actually put power on military bases that's fully within American control. And we think these reactors are perfect for that. This is a nice small form factor that's very easy to construct and is powerful enough to power a base if you put a couple of them together. So this is a really exciting opportunity, and we're willing to help our country in that way.
We've seen American military bases come under attack in recent years in different parts of the world. How would you guarantee the safety of this technology if it were to come under attack and not lead to some sort of meltdown?
Yeah, you know, this is where this particular technology shines. Our reactor is built around a very safe form of nuclear fuel called TRISO fuel. TRISO fuel is very small beads of uranium encased in very hard ceramic layers. And it turns out that these ceramic layers are extremely impervious to many different types of attacks. So if you look at the spectrum of how you build energy around the world, we believe this is actually the safest form of energy generation in the world. So we're really excited to put it out, not only on the edge, but also for data centers, heavy industrial power, and eventually synthetic hydrocarbon production.
Isaiah, before we let you go, is your company going to be the first U.S. company to successfully deploy and bring online a small modular reactor?
You know, it's a hot race, and there are a lot of awesome people working on the problem. But where I sit today, I do believe that Valar Atomics will be the first. That is absolutely our goal.